Discover the untamed beauty of Tanzania in East Africa. The land of breathtaking landscapes with its wonderful wildlife in an ever-changing cast. A story of the wild, about new life, growing up, family bonds, and learning the laws of the African wilderness. For survival is only for the courageous, the clever, and the strong. Tanzanians are proud of their country. They know what mysteries it conceals. In this series, you will explore Tanzania's richness in Tanzania's Best Kept Secret. In this episode, we travel to the north of Tanzania. Here we find families of rare forest elephants filing through the jungle on the slopes of Africa's iconic volcano, Mount Kilimanjaro. Among the highlights of nearby Arusha National Park are the alkaline lakes filled with flamingos and trees that abound with blue monkeys and the beautiful black and white colobus monkeys. In Africa's Great Rift Valley, a ragged chain of magnificent volcanoes dominates the surrounding savannas. The most famous of all, the tallest volcano in the world and an icon of Africa, is the Great White Mountain, Kilimanjaro. The crater at Kilimanjaro's summit stretches over half a kilometer across. Locked in by snow and ice, it's hard to believe that it once boiled over with molten lava. Kilimanjaro is so big, it creates its own weather system. When winds from the sea rise to the top of the mountain, clouds form. They deposit moisture on the peaks. This filters down through the porous lavaal rock and a labyrinth of underground aquifers until it surfaces in swamps and springs down below. Sudden changes in cloud cover and wind force can cause a drop of 20 degrees in as little as 30 minutes. At 4,000 meters, weird-looking giant lobelias are one of the few plants that can cope with such fluctuations. After each night spent tightly closed against the cold, lobelias open like a new flower to greet the rising sun. These plants rely on birds to pollinate them. Of all the animals living in the shadow of Kilimanjaro, none are more associated with it than elephants. For generations, they have been trailing up and down the Great White Mountain. Nowadays, these gentle giants are only found on the northern and western slopes. By mid to late afternoon, the herds start out on a march that will take them well beyond the park boundary. Many families move up the mountain where they find nutritious and tasty plants. These elephants are actually savanna elephants that happen to live in the forest. In comparison, their distant cousins, the real forest elephants, are only found in the green belt of the Congo Basin in West and Central Africa. Savanna elephants are bigger than forest elephants, and they have much larger and more curved tusks. Salt is one thing that will entice even the most retiring animal out into the open. Minerals are not found everywhere on the mountain. The soil gets washed away in many places. But there are exposed areas in the forest where mineral-rich veins in the soil have been uncovered by erosion. The elephants have the right tools to mine for salt. These forests are essential to other life on the mountain, for they provide it with a continuous supply of stored water. This lush belt of trees absorbs rainfall and moisture from the clouds. The mosses and lichens that cover everything in the forest act like a living sponge. Conquering this mountain is the dream of many visitors to Tanzania, and about 20,000 hikers climb it every year, following in the footsteps of Kili's forest elephants. Great White Mountain and its fairy tale forests give life to all that lives in its shadow. Close to Mount Kilimanjaro lies the beautiful Arusha National Park, the place where giraffes come out to greet you. Although it's relatively small, the Arusha National Park has it all. In the northeastern part of the park, the Momela lakes are teeming with flamingos. To the west, you'll find the rugged Mount Meru. Its slopes covered with dense forests, housing primates and many different species of antelopes. Southwards, there is the Ngurudoto crater, where all kinds of animals find a safe haven. This distinguished nose and large eyes belong to one of the smallest antelope species in Africa. At home in bushy, rocky areas with good cover, dik-diks are found in the forested crater area. Their remarkable noses actually function as coolers. The blood is cooled by nasal panting to help the species survive in hot and arid country. And where you see one, you'll often find a second. For dik-diks live in monogamous pairs and mate for life. But some of them fall victim to hungry predators. Among Arusha's prettiest inhabitants are black and white colobus monkeys. They are the symbol of the Arusha National Park. With an attractive long-haired coat and a bushy white tail, they are easily recognized. At birth, infants are completely white. They gain their black and white color within 4 to 5 months. They stay close to their mothers and live with other infants, females, and one or more adult male in small family groups. Black and white colobus monkeys are the most arboreal of all African monkeys. They rarely descend the trees to the forest floor. Their territory is usually relatively small, and different families live in close range of one another.
Arusha.
A cluster of several lakes is one of Arusha's best features. Most of the Momela lakes are alkaline, so animals can't use them for drinking. All the lakes contain different algae, giving them a distinctive color. The lesser flamingo are smaller than the greater flamingo, and they have pinker plumage and dark red bills. Flamingos use their large beaks to filter small food items from the water. The typical flamingo diet consists of diatoms, blue-green algae, crustaceans, and mollusks. One of the highlights in the Arusha region is the majestic Mount Lengai. In times of drought, the local Maasai tribes pray to what they call Odonyo Lengai, the mountain of God. The name suits it. A volcano almost 2 miles high, it dominates all it surveys. Today, the locals will make a sacrifice to the mountain in the hope of receiving rain. This is the coolest volcano in the world. The lava of Endangered Lengai erupts at such low temperatures it looks black. Weathering turns it gray. The rain ceremony ends. Now it's up to the mountain. Another volcano, Mount Meru, is visible throughout most of the park. On a bright day, views from this volcano are spectacular. The trees on top of this mountain are covered with an intimate combination of algae and fungi, which is referred to as old man's beard. Like children, baboon juveniles are active all day, playing, climbing, and investigating their surroundings. Survival in the forest requires great strength, climbing speed, agility, and this takes practice. The youngsters are accompanied by an example of what might happen in a fight. This full-grown male has lost part of his nose in an aggressive encounter over dominance. Baboons live in family groups with females, males, and young. A group can contain up to 200 individuals. Infants can live independently when they're about 20 months old. In an average group, more than half of the animals are immature. Adult baboons spend the day at an easy pace. While some gather food, others are bonding. Social grooming is a vital element in baboon society. An ordinary day typically begins with long grooming sessions. Relationships, coalitions, and rankings are determined and strengthened by who is grooming who. This attention-seeking loudmouth is the helmeted guinea fowl. Although it can fly, it usually prefers to walk. The guinea fowl are voracious insect eaters. they've developed a special relationship with some of the animals found here. By eating ticks and other livestock skin parasites, they free buffalo and waterbuck from their irritants. As long as they allow it, that is. This is the Ngudoto Crater. It's a reserve within the reserve. No vehicles or humans are allowed here. The Ngudoto Crater is a sanctuary of peace. And the views are spectacular. Giraffes are abundant in the Arusha National Park. In fact, the park has the highest concentration of giraffes anywhere in the world. Their long necks allow them to eat the leaves from the top of trees, leaving the lower leaves for smaller animals. Bee eaters feed on anything that flies. They sit and wait, and as soon as a bee or any other insect flies by, they catch it and eat it. The martial eagle has a good view of all that is moving in the grass below. A young crowned crane makes a good meal. The tall and majestic crowned crane normally lays 2 to 3 eggs, but in this family, only one chick survived. It's still vulnerable. The eagle is a potential danger to the young bird. Crowned cranes are monogamous birds. This couple will remain paired for life. Both parents share the responsibility of building the nest, incubating the eggs, and caring for the young. Crowned cranes can run as soon as they hatch, but it takes 10 weeks before they can fly. The cranes forage in open grasslands where they eat everything they can find: tips of grasses, seeds, insects, and other invertebrates. The eagle is looking for a snack himself. The parents are cautious and keep a close eye on the eagle. But the raptor is no threat to the young this time, for it has found another prey. It's an Egyptian goose, and although the eagle starts plucking its feathers, it hasn't died yet. The cranes don't feel comfortable as long as the eagle is around. Still wary, one of them bravely chases the eagle away. The hunter flees, and the prey is left alone, but with no chance of escape. Uncertain but curious, the crane investigates the eagle's catch of the day. It isn't sure what to do with the dying goose. Eventually, it loses interest in the bird, and the eagle returns to claim its catch. Like baboons, blue monkeys spend a great deal of their day eating and grooming. A lower-ranking monkey detects and removes fleas and ticks from a higher-ranking individual. But, of course, you can also groom yourself. Today, the peace and quiet is disturbed. Two youngsters lose themselves in a noisy fight. They seem deaf to the calls of their relatives. fall from the branches settles the argument, and all returns to normal. At the end of the day, even the younger black and white colobus monkeys relax. High up in the tree, the group is safe and at ease. But they want to find a better place to spend the night. To get there, they need to cross the road. Although cautious, black and white colobus monkeys sometimes do descend to the forest floor. It is their memorable appearance that makes them so special to Arusha National Park. The far north of Tanzania, home to elephants for generations past. Down below are the alkaline lakes where the abundance of flamingos tricks the eye into believing the lakes are bright pink. Dominated by a rugged chain of majestic mountains and craters, with views to take your breath away. A landscape so diverse, it's only equaled by the colorful parade of wildlife. An ideal habitat for the ever-energetic colobus monkey, blue monkey, and baboon. And the perfect habitat for all who live in the shadow of these majestic mountains.